In this video, we're going to take a look at running Lionel trains on DC power. And since I don't have a power supply that's capable of producing enough to run these trains, I just put a bridge rectifier and filter capacitor arrangement out here on my VW transformer. And as you can see, I have my 2025 locomotive running. And if it's in the mood, it will back up. And it's a lot happier here. A couple other things that we can do with it that I've experimented with. And by the way, the DC voltage that's running the train is showing on my multimeter here. So we can uncouple, as you see. We go back and reclaim our caboose. The other thing we can do when we're in the proper position is we can run our switches. And at the proper time, the crossing gate works. We'll run it another lap and we'll straighten out again. And then we're going to come around and we're going to try unloading, which is a little bit more of a challenge. So I'll see if I can first get the lumber car into position and see if that's happy. Mainly due to the E unit being a little bulky. Come on. Give it another try. Successful. So that's the lumber. See if we can come around and have a crack at the milkman. And these are the things that I found would work on DC power. And we're all done with this little demonstration. Alright, so here's our milkman. He's having some trouble here today. So he kind of threw the cans out, but nonetheless he did. And at this point, the only other thing that we might want to demo is if we get around here. Touching a wire to make the whistle sound. And I'm going to bring the demo to a close. And what I'm going to do next is to break away from the layout and just give a few minutes of explanation. But while I'm still here at the layout, you can see there are four large diodes connected to my ZW transformer. And you are actually watching DC voltage at the output of the diodes, a lot of filter capacitors to smooth out the ripple, and then finally you saw what was going to the track. Two other items that I've tested on DC, you see out in the middle the number 51 Navy Yard switcher and the number 60 trolley. The whistle is an American Flyer, but Lionel also made a whistle in a station house that can be remotely controlled. And what I'm going to do next is to talk about what can and can't operate on DC and why. So I'm going to pause this video and I'm going to move on to the next segment. So why might you want to run your Lionel trains on DC current? Well, one of the more obvious reasons is you don't have AC current available, or if you happen to live in Europe where the AC power line voltage is nominally 240 volts, there just aren't transformers around that'll run on 240. Lionel built a few, but apparently they're very, very scarce. I couldn't find one looking around the internet. So what you're relegated to is perhaps a DC power supply that can be used on a laboratory bench and is adjustable and is suitable for using a 240 volt AC input. And these are available. I've checked on the web. Major electronic distributors have them. And they're variable, some are even programmable. And cost-wise, they range from the low 100s to the mid 100s for ones that have sufficient power output to run a Lionel train, which is plan on at least 75 watts output. And with 12 volts, that means you need something with like 6 amps output capability. But on center stage, let me talk about two of the driving items when you're talking about running these trains on DC voltage. And by the way, the trains I'm going to talk about were those made from the 1940s through the 1950s. And basically, I can only talk about the ones that I own and you saw on the track. There are a lot of similar ones. For example, my 2025 was the twin for the number 675. And a lot of those were made from the late 1940s through the early 50s. But the beginning of the story really is this. This is a piece of an E-unit that I was using. I repurposed it to do something else. But inside of it is a plunger, which moves up and down when the power from the track is turned off. The plunger drops. When it's turned on, magnetic force generated by this coil pulls it up. Every coil through which you pass a current generates a magnetic field, and then in particular when you have a steel core, that magnetic field produces a force, and in this case the force is sufficient to pull up the plunger. Now the coil has two properties. Number one is the resistance of the very, very fine wire. I measured this coil. The wire is 12 thousandths of an inch thick, and the total resistance of this coil is about 12 ohms DC. And so if you're applying, say, 12 volts DC to the coil, then you have about 12 watts of power. That's a lot of power. This coil is going to get smoking hot with 12 watts on it. However, when you apply 60 cycles to this coil, the coil also takes on a property called inductance, which limits the amount of AC current that can pass through a coil of wire. And inductance is determined by the number of turns squared and the volume of the coil. So in this case, I applied 10 volts DC to the coil, and it took about 8/10 of an amp DC and began to get a little warm. I applied the same 10 volts AC to the same coil, and it only took about 6/10 of an amp. Now, if you relate that to absolute power, because the thing that makes heat in power is the resistance, this coil then would generate about 8 watts of heat with 10 volts applied, with DC applied. But if 60 cycles were applied, that would only generate about 4 watts, which is a comfortable amount of power. So you can see there's a huge difference, almost 2-to-1. So when you're running with trains with DC, you have to be very, very careful that the applied voltage does not overheat and burn out the E-unit. That's kind of be the end of the train in most cases for a lot of people. So here is a similar apparatus to the one that I put on my ZW to power the track. This is a packaged bridge rectifier. I think it's rated at 10 amps. So you put your AC voltage here and your DC comes out these two terminals, and I connected four high-valued capacitors to it. And at the other end are my red, which is plus, and blue, my minus. So that's what I use to produce DC. However, probably if you're sitting over in Europe, you're going to end up buying a laboratory power supply to produce the DC. So that's the short story of the ups and downs of DC, and every item that you saw on the layout was obviously able to run with somewhere between 10 and 12 volts DC. Now, that doesn't mean that everything is going to be happy. So let's take a look at things that I tried that don't run on DC. So I'm going to change my camera setting, and we're going to look out here in the hinterlands. And starting from left to right, we have our whistle. I disconnected the whistle that's inside the coal tender of this engine because this is a DC operated relay. And basically this whistle would operate constantly if the train ran on DC. So we can't have that, which is why you saw I substituted the American Flyer whistling billboard, which doesn't have this relay, but the motor does run on DC. Here's a crossing signal I used to like a lot. I forget what the number is, but anyway, the arm would swing when you applied power to it. And another one of my favorite accessories when I was young was the cattle set. Both of these rely on vibration, and the vibration is only possible when you're applying 60 cycles to these. So the cattle set will not work because it won't vibrate with DC. This didn't work because it didn't vibrate. Last but not least, the ever popular Lionel Gate Man. His problem was he simply just took way too much power. And if you applied enough DC to pop him out, the train would overrun and go crazy. So I opted to leave him behind. Possibly you could play with a second DC supply to run just your Gate Man if you had to have it, but it probably wouldn't be worth it. So these are things that I happen to have in my personal collection that were not suitable for DC. But everything you saw on the track did run, and if you're in a pinch and don't have the ability to get an AC transformer, you can consider purchasing a DC power supply. So that's the story. I hope it's been informative and useful. Hopefully you have a great day and stay safe. As always, thanks for watching.